The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is. 7th chapter, text number 1. Given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Recorded on the 16th of February, 1973, in Sydney, Australia.
Yugam Dindan Malakra Asankhayam Samadbrahma Yatha This is a verse from Bhagavad Gita. How to develop Krishna consciousness or bhakti? The Bhagavad Gita, most of you have heard about the name of this book. It is very widely read book of knowledge throughout the whole world. Practically in every country there are many editions of Bhagavad Gita. So the Bhagavad Gita is the basic principle of our Krishna consciousness moment. What we are reading as Krishna consciousness, that is only Bhagavad Gita. It is not that we have manufactured anything. The Krishna consciousness is existing since the creation. But at least for the last 5,000 years, when Krishna was present on this planet, He personally instructed Krishna consciousness, and the instruction is left behind me. This is Bhagavad Gita. Unfortunately, this Bhagavad Gita has been misused in so many ways by the so-called scholars and samis. The impersonalist class or atheist class of men, they have interpreted Bhagavad Gita in their own way. When I was in America in 1966, one American lady asked me to recommend an English edition of Bhagavad Gita so that she could read it. But honestly, I could not recommend any one of them on account of their theoretical explanation. That gave me impetus to write Bhagavad Gita as it is. And this present edition, Bhagavad Gita as it is now published by Macmillan Company, the biggest publisher in the world. And we are doing very nice. We published this Bhagavad Gita as it is in 1968, a small edition. It was selling like anything. The sales manager of Macmillan Company reported that our books are selling more and more, others are reducing. Then, recently in this 1972, we have published this Bhagavad Gita as it is, complete edition. And Macmillan Company published 50,000 copies in August, but it was finished in 3 months. And they are arranged for second edition. So, this Bhagavad Gita should be read by every individual person, to know the science of God. It is a great science. God is not a fiction or an imagination as people take it. Not always, but in human society, everywhere, in civilized human society, there is some conception of religion, and the purpose of executing religious faith means to understand God. There is no other purpose of any religion. If in any religion the understanding of God is lacking, that is not first class religion. So, we are preaching not any particular type of religion. Religion is described in English dictionary as a kind of faith. Actually, religion does not mean the Sanskrit word dharma. That dharma means character. It is not a kind of faith. Character or occupational duty. So generally it means character. The characteristic is that every living being, it does not mean whether it is animal or human being or tree or plant or insect. Every living being has a particular characteristic that is visible in all kinds of forms of living being. That is service. Everyone is remaining in service. Here we are so many ladies and gentlemen present, but every one of us is remaining in some service to the superior. That is our belief. The animals also, the inferior animals, they are rendering service to the superior animal. The superior animal is eating the inferior animal. Jiva jivasya jivana. Big snake is eating small snake. There is a verse in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Apadanam chatuspadam. Those who are two-legged, they are eating the four-legged. And the four-legged animals, they are eating who cannot walk. Apadanam chatuspadam. Those who cannot move, that's like grass, plant, tree, they cannot move. They are being eaten up by the four-legged animals. And the four-legged animals are being eaten by two-legged animals, human beings. Just try to understand how the weaker section is serving this stronger section. That is the law of nature. Jiva jivasya jivana. One living entity is the food or living means for another living entity by nature's law. So the conclusion is that we must render service to the strong. This is nature's law. Now, that being position, we all living entities, we are weaker. And the strongest is the supreme law. Therefore, our business is to render service to the supreme law. We are rendering service to the stronger section, but the strongest of all stronger is the supreme law. Therefore, the conclusion is that our normal position is to render service to God. This is the conclusion. We cannot say that we don't care for God, and that we cannot say. We are so dependent on God's mercy that we cannot say. Just like today, this evening, when we are coming in this hall, there are heavy rain. So this heavy rain, I'm coming from India and other parts, there is drought, there is no rainfall, there is suffering for want of rainfall. But in Australia, especially in Sydney, I see there is good rainfall. So how the distinction can be adjusted? In some places there is no rainfall, but here we have got sufficient rainfall at the present moment. It is God's mercy. You cannot do it where there is shortage of rainfall. They cannot bring in rainfall by their scientific advancement of knowledge. That is not possible. You have to depend on God, on the mercy of God. What is this rainfall? This rainfall is an arrangement, taking water from the sea and spread all over the surface of the land. But you cannot do it. The sea water you can spread by pumping or by some other means, but that will not serve your purpose. The sea water must be distilled. It must be made into sweetness. Then such rainfall will give you some effect in producing agricultural products and so on. So every way we are dependent on the Supreme Personality of God. When we speak of Krishna, we mean the Supreme Personality of God. So here Krishna is teaching himself. God is teaching himself. What is God? What is science of God? You cannot speculate on the science of God. God may be like this, God may be like that. No. You have to know God from God himself. That's like you cannot speculate about the position of a very big man. Suppose there is a very big man in your country, if you speculate about him at home, the knowledge is never perfect. It cannot. Speculative knowledge is never perfect, especially when you imagine something about somebody. That is all humbug. It has no meaning. So God cannot be realized by speculation. But here is a chance wherein God is speaking about himself. So you can understand what is God. Now in this verse, Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Maya sakta mana parthya yugam junyan madasraya asamsam samagrama yathagyasasi tatsuno. My dear Arjuna, if you develop your attachment for me, mayasaka, attachment for me, God is God. We have got attachment. Every one of us has got some attachment, either for this or that, especially our living condition means to love someone. That love, propensity, that loving propensity is there within me, within you. I want to love you, or you want to love me, or I want to love somebody, but I want to love. That is my hankering. But because the love is misplaced, therefore we are frustrated. Love is misplaced. The example is given in the Shastra. Just like the tree has to be watered. But if we do not know the purpose of watering, where to water, then our business of watering will be misused. You cannot water on the leaves, on the trees, or on the branches. You have to pour water on the roof. That is the principle. So our loving propensity, when it will be properly employed, when we try to love or develop our loving propensity for God, or directly when we learn how to love God, then our loving propensity is perfect. Then you can love others also. It is not just like watering the root of the tree. You automatically pour water in the other parts of the tree. Or supplying foodstuff in the stomach. You supply foodstuff to all the parts of the body. Similarly, if you can develop your love for God, that is already there. It is not an artificial thing. In the Chaitanya Charitamrita it is said that Nitya Siddha Krishna Bhakti Sardhaka Gunam. Our loving propensity or our love for God is already there in every living being. But it is now covered due to our ignorance or due to our contamination with this material nature. So simply, we have to awaken that love. That is our business. That awakening of love cannot be possible in other living condition than the human being. The human being, the human form of life is therefore the perfectional stage how to develop our love for God. Or how we can love God. This is the main business of human life. Athat Brahma Jignasa. The Vedanta Sutra says that this life is especially meant for developing or inquiring about our love with Krishna or God. This is the only business. Athat Brahma Jignasa. So, that love for Krishna or God, how you can develop or how you can awaken, that is explained by Krishna in this verse. Maya saptamana prartha yogam junyan madara. You have to increase your attachment for Krishna or God. According to Srimad Bhagavatam, the first class religion is that which teaches the follower how to love God. This is first class. Savai punsham karo dharma jato bhakti radhokat. Ahuituki apratihata jayatma samprasidati. If you want actually peace of your mind or your self, then you must learn how to love God. Because you are hankering to love the Supreme. But because you have not no information of the Supreme, you are placing your love, your body, your society, your country, your family, or if you haven't got anything to love, then you get a dog, cat, and you love it. The loving propensity is there. This is the secular. Now that loving propensity can attain its perfection. And as soon as you reach that perfectional point, you become happy. This is the formula of happiness. Everyone is trying to become happy, peaceful. That peacefulness, that happiness can be attained only when you increase your attachment and love the Supreme Personality of God. This is the meaning of Krishna consciousness movement. We are not teaching any kind of faith. There are many different types of faith. So, but unfortunately, maybe due to the slackness of this movement, of religious movement, people have lost all faith in religious movement. Maybe there are many reasons, but it cannot be left aside. You cannot give up. If you want actually peace of the mind, peace of yourself, then you must try to love God. That is the only way. Sabai pungsan paro dharma. So how to love Krishna and God? That is being instructed by Krishna. Maya sattva. You have to increase your attachment for Krishna. When I speak of Krishna, you should take it God, the Supreme Personality of God. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, each Supreme Personality of Godhead has got any suitable name, perfect name. God may have many thousands of names, but the most perfect name which he can give to the Supreme Personality of Godhead is Krishna. Krishna means all attractive. God must be all attractive. It is not that God is attractive for a certain class of man and not attractive for others. We'll find the picture of Krishna. Here is Krishna's picture, and there are many other pictures also. Here is also. He is attractive to the animals, he is attractive to the trees, he is attractive to the flowers, he is attractive to the water, and what to speak of human being. He is attractive. Therefore his name is Krishna. Krishna means all attractive. So if any suitable name can be assigned to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, it is Krishna. That is the verdict of the Vedic literature. Now Krishna says, if you develop your attachment for me, maya satta mana partha, my dear Arjuna, maya satta mana partha yogam junyan madasa. It is a yoga, yoga system. You have heard the name of yoga system. There are different kinds of yoga system. But the foremost and the topmost yoga system is to develop your attachment or constantly be in touch with the Supreme Personality of God. That is first class yoga. Yoga actually means to make your connection with the Supreme Lord. That is yoga. Yoga means addition, connect. And vyoga, the opposite word is vyoga. Just like addition and subtraction. Similarly, the yoga and the opposite word is viyoga or vyoga. Vyoga means when we are detached from God, and yoga means when you are attached to God. This is the two different words. So here it is recommended yogam junjanmadatha. It is a another practice of yoga, the topmost yoga. And previous to this verse, there is another verse. Yoginamati sarvesam madgata antarakana sadhyanam bhajati juma sami yukta tamomata. That is sixth chapter. I am speaking from the seventh chapter. The sixth chapter of Bhagavad Gita concludes with this verse that yoginamati sarvesam. There are different types of yogis. But the most important yogi, or the topmost yogi is he who is always thinking of me, Krishna says, who is always thinking of God. He is first class yogi. Yoginamati sarvesham madgata antaratmana. Yoga means that. Always thinking of God. Dhyanavasthita tadgatena manasa vasyantijam yogin. The yogi's business is that he is always meditating upon the form of the Supreme Personality of God. That is yoga. Madhgata antarātma. These are the Vedic verses. That dhyanavasthita. Dhyana means meditation. Dhyanavasthita tadgatena. just being absorbed in the thought of God, Krishna, one who is meditating, jnana-vastita-tadvata-yena-manasa, mind is so trained up that mind cannot think of anything else except God. That is Parikshana-dhu. Our mind cannot be vacant. We must think of something in the mind. Not for a second we can make our mind vacant. That is not possible. So this vacancy, this mind business, thinking, feeling and willing, where all of them are engaged in the Supreme Personality of Godhead, that is called perfect yoga system, or the topmost yoga system. Unfortunately, the impersonalists, they have no idea of the form of the law. Because they are impersonalists, they do not accept any form of the law. But there is the form of the law. Form of the law, there must be. Yeah. God is accepted as the Supreme Father. In Christianity also it is accepted, the Supreme Father. In every religion, He is accepted the Supreme Person, Supreme Father, Supreme Master. So how He can be impersonal? From logical point of view, just that you are a person, your father is a person, his father is also a person. His father is also a person, God. Even you do not know your topmost forefather, you know it, that he was a person. Similarly, the Supreme Father, the father of all fathers, how he can be impersonal? Logically you cannot conceive. He must be a person. And that is the Vedic version also. Brahmeti Paramahmeti Bhagavaneti Sabda. Vadanti tat-tattavidat-tatyam jad-jnanam-adyam brahmeti paramatmeti bhagavaneti sam. The Supreme Absolute Truth is one, but He is realized from different angles of vision. Those who are trying to realize the Supreme Absolute Truth by speculation, they come to the impersonal conclusion. And those who are trying to think about him within the heart, jnana-vastita, that is the yogic principle, to think of the Supreme within the heart. He is there within the heart. Both the living entity, individual living entity and God, is sitting within this heart. That's a fact. We have to search it out, catch it, by yogic process. So those who are trying to understand the Absolute Truth by speculative method, they come to the conclusion of impersonalism. And those who are trying to capture the Supreme Personality of Godhead within the heart, yogi, paramatma, they understand Krishna or God as paramatma, the super soul. Ishara sarva-bhutanam riddhesa arjuna tishtha. They will find in the Bhagavad Gita. Ishara, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, He is sitting in everyone's heart. Not only human being, even animals, everyone. So that feature is called Paramatma. But the ultimate feature is Bhagavan. Bhagavan means the Supreme Personality of God. Bhagavan means opulence. There are six kinds of opulences. So, the Supreme Personality of Godhead is the possessor of all the opulences, and He is a person. These are the Vedic verses. Ishara Parama Krishna. We are also, because we are part and parcel of God, we may be called as sample God. Sample God. Just like in Christian Bible also to say that man is made after the form of the God. Actually that. We have got two legs, two hands, this form. This is after God's form. God has also the same form like human being. It takes some time to understand. It's a great science. Anyway, our position is, we learn from Bhagavad Gita that we have to increase our attachment for God, Krishna, Maya Shakti. This is the perfect process of yoga system. And if you simply increase your attachment for Krishna, then Asam Swayam, without any doubt, Samagra, and in fullness, you can understand what is God. This is Krishna consciousness movement. We have got our Krishna's form, just like you see Krishna is playing on his flute. Here is also Krishna is standing with his brother Balaram. So Krishna is sometimes with Radharani. So you are seeing Krishna Radha, Radha Krishna in our temple. Those who have not seen, we invite all of you to our temple. There is Radha Krishna Diti. So this process, Krishna consciousness movement, is to teach people how to increase his attachment for Krishna. There are many processes. Beginning of the Krishna consciousness is sraddha, a little faith. That is the beginning. Adho sraddha. Sraddha means to accept that this is a nice moment. This is a nice moment, just like you have come here with this sraddha, little faith. So what these people are making in Krishna consciousness movement, let us go and see. This is called sraddha. This is the first thing. So you have to increase this sraddha. How? Adho sraddha tato sadhu sanam. If you want to increase this sraddha, then you have to make association with the devotee. Just like all these European, American, Canadian, and all my devotees, they came first to me when I began this Krishna consciousness movement in New York. I was chanting underneath the tree, and these boys and girls were coming. So that was sraddha. And as they gradually came to me, that is called sadhusam. So anything you want to learn, you must associate with such kind of men. If you want to learn business, there are so many business corporation associations. So sometimes you become member in stock chain and other association to learn that business or make progress in that business. Similarly, if you want to increase your love for Krishna, for God, you must associate with persons who are interested in this business. Devotees. These devotees have no other interest. All these boys and girls who are under my direction, they have no other interest, simply Krishna. So we have to associate with such persons. Adhu sadhya tatu sadhu sangha. Sadhu sangha means associate with the devotee. Adhu sadhya tatu sadhu sangha. Sadhu, sadhu, this word, Sanskrit word, is meant for the devotee, the lover of Krishna. That is also explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Sadhu deva samam. Apite sudura sarva bhajate imam ananna bha. Sadhu deva samam. One who has unflinching faith in Krishna, one who is 100% engaged to render service to Krishna, he is called sadhu. Sadhu does not mean a kind of dress or kind of beard, no. Sadhu means a devotee, perfect devotee of Krishna. That is his sadhu. Therefore, it is recommended sadhu sanga. We have to associate with sadhu. Means who have completely dedicated life for Krishna's self. That is the injunction in Bhagavad Gita. Manmana bhavamad bhakta madhya dhimam namaskuru. This process is very simple. Krishna advises himself. How to become a sadhu? How to become a saintly person? That is also. Only you follow four principles. Manmana bhavamad bhakta. You simply think of Krishna. manmana. He just became devotee of Krishna. Manmana bhavamad madhyadi. He simply worshipped Krishna. Manmana bhavamad madhyadi. Mana namaste. You offer your obeisances. These four things. Think of Krishna. Like thinking of Krishna we have introduced. We have not introduced. It is introduced from Vedic literature. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. If you chant the 16 words, it is not very difficult. Anyone, there is no secrecy, there is no charge for it. We don't say that I shall give you some secret mantra and give me some money. No, we don't say. We openly chant this Hare Krishna mantra. Anyone can chant also. But see the effect of chanting this. That is up to you. If you begin chanting, you will feel effect very soon. So, this is called Varmana, always thinking of Krishna. As soon as one chants Hare Krishna, immediately he remembers Krishna. He immediately remembers Krishna's activities, Krishna's pastimes, Krishna's form, Krishna's quality, Krishna's attributes, everything. That is God. You have got the mind in Krishna. That means you become immediately the first class yogi. Yoginamati sarvisnam mangatantanatma. This is the process. So, these boys and girls who have taken to Krishna consciousness movement seriously, they are all first class yogis. Because they are always thinking of Krishna. Manmana bhavamad bhakta. So, Adusha Dasso, if you want to develop Krishna consciousness, then you can be associated with these devotees. We are opening so many centers all over the world. We have already 102 centers. Just to give opportunity to all classes of men to associate with devotees and develop your love for God. This is the purpose. We have no other purpose. These centers are being opened. So I request it. Those who are interested in loving God, in Krishna consciousness, they will kindly associate with this devotee. Adu sadhya tatu sadhu dhamma. And these devotees, this is our method. When a man, a gentleman or lady comes to our association, he associates with us for 3 months, 6 months, then automatically he desires to be initiated. Adu sadhya tatu sadhu dhamma tatha bhajana kriya. Bhajana kriya means one becomes anxious. The effect of sadhu sangha is to become anxious. How to execute this devotional service properly? That is called initiation. So they come forward. The president recommends that this boy or girl is now living with us for so many months. He is interested. He may be initiated. Then we initiate. But initiate with some condition. Anarthani with Krishna, these are the different stages. Initiation means that he must be free from all kinds of sinful activities. These four principles, the pillars of sinful activities, are four in number. Initiate sex life, meat eating, intoxication and gambling. Sriyasana Panam. So automatically they do. All these boys and girls who are sitting here, you know that they have given up. Automatically they have been able. By association with Krishna, it has become very practical and easy thing to give up all these four principles of sinful activities. Because without being pure, you cannot understand the Supreme Pure. God is Supreme Pure. It is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Jesam antagatam papam janana punya karmana. Anyone who is completely free from the reaction of sinful life. Jesam antagatam papam janana punya karmana. Now, how it is possible? If one is simply engaged in pious activities. The most pious activity is to be engaged in Krishna consciousness movement. Pure. Then these are the different stages. Adu sadhya tatu sadhu sangha tatu vajana kriya atha anartha nivitti syat. Anartha means things we do not want. Artificially we have practiced to think. Just like meat eating. Meat eating, if we do not practice it from the beginning of our birth. Just after birth, the child, the baby requires little honey or little milk, not the meat. But afterwards, the parents or the guardians teach him how to eat meat. This is not a human business. Human teeth is meant for eating fruits and grains. That is scientific. Our teeth is made in that. So anyway, meat eating, intoxication, illicit sex, as soon as one takes to Krishna consciousness movement, these four pillars of sinful life is immediately broken. Adu sudhya tatu sadhu sangha tatu vajana kriya athan arthan vittishyat tatu nishtha. As soon as one becomes free from all sinful activities, he becomes wholly convinced of God consciousness. That is called nishtha. Tato nishtha, tato ruchi. Then you taste. Ah, it is so nice, Krishna consciousness. That tato nishtha. Sadhu sadhya tato sadhu sangha tato bhajana kriya tato anartha nivittishya tato nishtha tato ruchi. Tatha asakti, then asakti. What is Krishna is recommending here? Asakti means attachment. So this attachment comes after passing over so many different stages of devotional service. So Krishna is recommending maya asakti. You have to increase your attachment for Krishna and God. So by practicing this process, to come to the state of asakti, mayasaktamana, then your mind becomes completely attracted by Krishna. Tato bhava, the next step. Khadukana ayam prema pradubhavi bhavitrama. These are the different stages to develop your love for God or Krishna. So this is not very difficult. Anyone can practice. How it is difficult? These European American boys, they were never practiced to it, not in their family or by culture. But because Krishna consciousness is there in everyone's heart, simply by little practice, it comes, it develops. So we request that to make your life successful, this human form of life, you practice this, Krishna consciousness or God consciousness. That is the success of life. Not to live like any. Simply eating, sleeping, sex intercourse and defense. They are the business of the animal soul. If we develop simply in these four principles of animal life, that is not advancement of civilization. The advancement of civilization is tested when a nation or person is interested to inquire about God. That is advanced. Athato brahma jignasu. This is advanced. How a nation or person is advanced to inquire about God or about himself? God and we are of the same quality. Because it is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, that's a fact. God is the supreme living being. And we are also living here. But he is the head, supreme. That is the description in the Vedas. Nitya, Nityana, Sitana, Sitanana, Eka, Ju, Bahunam, Vidudhati, Kaman. These are the description in the Vedas. That God means that as we are person, he is the supreme person. That's all. Just like you are also person, you are also Australian. And the president of the Australian government, he is also a person. He is not impersonal. The government may be impersonal. But the head of the government is a person. Similarly, in the universal government, there are so many living entities, just like we are, not only human beings, 8,400,000 species of life, all living entities. A God is also a living entity, but He is the supreme living. That is the difference. Yeah. Nitya nityanam chitana chitanana. So, as we act under the leadership of a supreme person, similarly, if we live under the leadership of God, that is our perfection of life. This is called yogam janyan madasra. Madasra means under my direction. So what is the direction of God? Just become His devotee, just think of Himself, always about Him, just offer Him obeisances. This is the process. It is not very difficult. And if you cannot do anything, simply if you chant the holy name of God. We do not say that you chant the name of Krishna. If you have got any name, holy name of God, you can chant that also. But chant, this is the process recommended in this age. Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Iva Kevalam, Kalo Nastiva, 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 Gatiranatha. In this age, it is very difficult to develop Krishna consciousness and God consciousness. People are so downfall. But there is only one method. If you can chant the holy name of God, it will help you very quickly. So we do not say, if you think that Krishna name is the Hindu name or Indian name, why shall I chant that? But if you have got any name, actually it must be name of God, not a fiction or an idea. Just like I have already explained, this Krishna Sanskrit word means all attractive. When the greatest, you say the God is great, Krishna means the greatest, all attractive. Unless you become very great, you cannot be attractive. According to our material calculation, if one is very rich, he is attractive. If one is very influencer, he is attractive. If one is very wise, he is attractive. If one is very beautiful, he is attractive. In this way, we attract. So God, Krishna has got all the six opulences of attraction. Therefore, He is called Krishna. So, our recommendation is, not our, it is the recommendation of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who inaugurated or revitalized this Krishna consciousness movement 500 years ago in Bengal as Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He said, Nam-nam-kari bahudha nita-sadva-shakti tat-prajita niyamita smaranenakar. Nam-nam-kari, the name and the person whose name, there is, because God is absolute, there is no difference between His name and He Himself. That's why in this material calculation, if you want water, simply by chanting water, water, you won't get water. The water substance is different from the name water. But God being absolute, His name, His form, His quality, His entrance, they're all the same, as good as God. So if you associate with any one of them, either God personally, or with His name, or with His form, or with His quality, or with His paraphernalia, immediately you become in contact with God. This is the sign. This is not fixed, this is sign. Because if you accept God absolute, there cannot be difference between God and His name and His form. So this is sign. You will realize, as you make progress, you realize, just like this boy, they are chanting Hare Krishna mantra. They are realized. Otherwise, I am not bribed. They are mad after Hare Krishna mantra. It is not due to my bribing. They are actually realizing that they are interested in Krishna. So anyone can do that. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says therefore that there are many thousands of names of God. Although we say that the only perfect name is Krishna. But if you think that you have got another, that's all right. But it must be the name of God. It must be full with the conception of God. If you have God, you can chant that name also. There is no hindrance. The nam nam kar, because every name being identical with God, every name of God is as powerful as God. As powerful, because identical. Identical, therefore, every name has got the same power and potency as the Supreme Person God has got. Nam nam kari bhuda, nija sarva shakti, nija sarva shakti. All potencies are there. Tatrarthita, there is, it is already endowed with all the potencies. The Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, itadisi tava kripa bhagavan mamati duddhaiva idrisamiha janina anurada. My dear Lord, you have sent in this age your name, which is full of potencies, as much potencies you have got. Still, I am so unfortunate that I cannot chant even your holy name. It is so nice. You haven't got to do anything. Simply try to chant the holy name of God. Then gradually everything will evolve within, because within you everything is there. Simply you have to accept the process and everything will come out. Cheta dharpana marjanam. Our misunderstanding is due to dirty things within our heart. So first benefit of chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra will be that all the dirty things within your heart will be clean. Cheta dharpana marjanam. Bhava mahadava nimitvata. And immediately you will be released from the blazing fire of this material existence. This material existence is compared with a blazing forest fire. Forest fire means nobody goes to set fire in the forest, but it takes place automatically. Similarly, in this material world, however peacefully you want to live, without God consciousness, you cannot live peacefully. It is not possible. Forget. Therefore, if you think of Krishna or God always, immediately you will be free from the conflagration of blazing fire of this material. Cheta dharpana marjanam bhava mahadavagni nibbapanam. And as soon as this blazing fire of material existence is extinguished, immediately you come to the platform of this Krishna. Cheta dharpana marjanam bhava mahadavagni nibbapanam. Shriya Kairava Chandrika, then that blissfulness will increase one after another, one after. Just like the comparison has been given, just like the moon, they after the dark moon, the moon comes out, just like a light, then it increases, and one night it becomes full moon. Similarly, as your heart becomes clean of the material dirty thing, your real form, Satchidananda Vigraha, eternity, blissful life of knowledge, becomes visible, just like the moon is visible, and one day you come to the full pleasure, full moon night, and that is your Sarvatma Sapana, and at that time you'll enjoy your life like anything. That is our first perfection of life. Param Vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtana. The only method is chanting this holy name of God, Krishna. So, because Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu chanted the 16 names, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Therefore, we also follow the footprints of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We are also chanting the same Hare Krishna Mahamantra. And we shall request you also, there is no expenditure, there is no loss on your part. But if there is any gain, why don't you try? That is our request. Chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. This is the process of increasing your attachment for God and Krishna. And as soon as you increase your love, that is our real constitutional position, to love God. We are loving also in this fallen state, but not God or non-God or some shadow God. But when you come to the real stage of loving God, then at that time our life becomes perfect. And it is said in the Brahma Sangita, Premanyana Surita Bhakti Vilochanena Santa Sadaiva Hridayeshu Vilokan. When you develop your love of God, Krishna, then you see God every moment, every step. Santa Sadaiva. Sadaiva means always. People say, can you show me God? There is no need of showing God. You qualify yourself and God will be visible in every step of your life. Then your life will be successful. Thank you. Please. Why the rainy season is there? Can you answer? Why the rainy season is there? Why it is raining? These are periodical changes. Just like there is summer season, winter season, rainy season. Similarly, this material world is subjected to the seasons or changes. It is called jagat. Jagat means which is changing. But we do not like this changing because we are eternal. We have been put into this condition, changing condition. Therefore we are not happy. So this Krishna consciousness movement means to get ourselves out of this changing condition to the eternal condition. It is very, intelligent question. Why there is Kali Yuga? Kali Yuga means these ages are changed, just like the same way. As there is summer season, there is rainy season, after rainy season, there is winter season. Similarly, there are four yugas, namely Satya Yuga, Treta Yuga, Dwapara Yuga and Kali Yuga. Satya Yuga means perfect age. And then Treta Yuga, one-fourth less of perfection. And then Dwapara Yuga, half less. And Kali Yuga, three-fourth less. Three-fourth bad element and one-fourth good element. That is also very rare. So, but if we take to Krishna consciousness, we become transcendental. We have nothing to do with the seasonal changes or Kali Yuga. That is recommended. Kalu, nastiva, 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 gatiranda. If we take to Krishna consciousness, then we are not affected by the bad effects of Kali Yuga. That is it. Kali Yuga is disagreement and fight. This is called Kali Yuga. Here, at the present moment, in this age, everyone disagrees with other and they fight. Therefore, it is called Kali Yuga.
What do you know Krishna is about?
Yes. Because Jesus Christ says that he is Son of God and Krishna says he is God. Therefore he is Father of Jesus Christ.